The video industry at the beginning of the 80s, it was the Wild West. There were no rules because we didn't want there to be any rules. If you can think of it, you can do it. And that became our kind of maxim for the next 10 years.
The Music Video Exposed takes you behind the lens of the most iconic videos ever created. It was the directors that called the shots, and their work could make you or break you. This episode features the work of visionary director Kevin Godley.
There is always a hierarchy, and we were the ones that people wanted. Lol Cream and I were in a band called 10cc, which was very successful in the 1970s. And when we left the band, we started to make records for ourselves, and we wanted to make a little film, which we did. Before we knew what was going on, we were video directors, and we had a ball.
Why did we choose Kevin and Lol? Because first and foremost, they were musicians.
They made some terrific records, and it was sort of fascinating to us that they'd moved into video so early and that they wanted to develop this.
Nobody had done anything quite like what they did with Rocket.
You know, when you've got a song and you're looking around for people, you just think, and he was one of those,
He's totally fearless, he's unflappable, and he will make it work somehow.
The first time he took off the wig, that really threw me out.
He gets physical, that's what I found
he's
the most
brute.
Difficult. And the tattoos, when he strips down, you know, when he's really going for it, he strips down, that's scary.
Enormous,
yeah, that's but, you know, that's what you have to deal with.
When video came along, it was a new toy, it was a new sandpit we could play in. And we worked incredibly hard at it, but we played incredibly hard at it as well. The first thing we did for the police was Every Breath You Take, which is quite sophisticated for its time. And I think that the work that we did kind of upped their game. Every
breath you take. We trusted Kevin and Lol to come up with something original. You know, I think they managed to come up with something that was seminal and, you know, kind of an archetype that, you know, a lot of people copied. It was simple. It was a very simple video. Just stark black and white colors. I always like black and white because I'm colorblind. But I always think there's more information in black and white film than there is in color film. Every game you play, every night you stay, I'll be watching. Well, you know, I have to say, my approach to videos was to leave it to the directors. You know, it was always nice to have a sort of oblique angle on the song, a sort of strange take on it, because it wasn't so literal. You know, people get the wrong impression of a song, what the lyric is about. I never contradict them. Every Breath You Take, for example, is a very dark song about control and jealousy and surveillance. Some people think it's a romantic song that they would like played at their wedding. I'm serious. I'll never contradict them. In fact, that's what it's about. But, you know, Kevin and Noel's interpretation visually was loose enough and flexible enough for all of those things to be still there.
Well, actually, it has dated. Every Breath has dated. There's some cack moments in it, like towards the end when we freeze things and they pull apart stills, which look a bit now. But in general, as a piece of black and white photography and just very simple performance, it works very well.
Still to come, Sting's Fields of Gold tip Kevin over the edge.
I've never thrown a tantrum before on a set, but this time I did. I threw a chair at the motion control rig.
And U2's Edge takes centre stage.
There was that much jeopardy. It almost didn't happen.
You know, Kevin and Lol have always had a great wit about them, a great sense of humor. They bounced the ideas off each other. It was always very electric to be around them as they threw ideas in.
I have to say, we probably single-handedly kept the economy of the Lebanon afloat for 10 years during that period of time, if you know what I mean.
You know, Fields of Gold didn't seem to involve very much work for me. I like that idea. The work would be done elsewhere and I could go home and get on with my life, you know, which is making music and being a dad. You remember me when the west wind moves. I wrote it in my home. At the time I lived in Wiltshire in England. My house was surrounded by fields of barley. And it's a song about continuity. It's a song about romance, memory.
It was based on a book cover that I saw. And I can't remember what the book cover was called.
It was called The Peaceful Warrior. And I've forgotten the name of the writer, but the book cover showed the outline of a silhouette of a man, but you could see through the silhouette into a scene.
And I always thought, when they invent the technology to allow me to move around an image like that, it would make an interesting video. And then motion control came along. So you can, you know, film it during the day, film it at night, have it raining, have it, you know, and it will repeat the same move exactly. Or it won't. Suddenly it's midnight, the motion control rig goes and stops. And what's wrong? It's nothing. And just give me 10 minutes. Still not working. A bit of research, lift up the hood, see what's going on, check the oil and water, tyres. And a little rubber grommet, which is obviously a very significant rubber grommet, had broken. Do they carry spare rubber grommets, do they? I've never thrown a tantrum before on a set, but this time I did. And I threw a chair at the motion control rig. And my relationship with the technology has not been a good one ever since. It's one of those pieces of equipment that's great. I can't make it work. When I'm in the room with one of these things, they break.